Good morning, Kitchissippi. It's the morning of Saturday, January 16th. And of course, the big news this week is that the Scott Street detour for LRT construction will begin tomorrow on Sunday. Writ large, the LRT means that the transitway next to us has to be converted over to light rail. The buses won't be able to travel on it anymore. So beginning tomorrow, in a first phase, the buses are going to begin entering and exiting the transitway to continue their journey to the West End. Here at Merton Street, there's a new entrance and set of lights that you can see behind me to control the traffic. It's going to be fairly disruptive. I've included in this video a little animation to describe how the new lane configurations are going to work. But beginning tomorrow, there will be upwards of 125 buses per hour in any given direction, particularly at the peak hour. There are a couple of things I want to show you this morning, particularly a new multi-use path for pedestrians and cyclists that might make your trip across the O-Train a little bit more comfortable rather than having to take the Albert Street Bridge. The lanes right next to me, there is a bicycle lane, but I think folks may be a little bit more comfortable if they're on the multi-use path. I'm going to be here next week on Monday to take a look at how the traffic is going. I'm going to be looking for things like an excessive amount of cut-through traffic. I expect it's going to be fairly disruptive over the course of the first week. It's going to take a while for traffic patterns to calm down. If you see anything you think I should know about, by all means, give me a call or drop my office a line at jeff.leeper@ottawa.ca, and we'll work with OC Transpo and with the Light Rail Implementation Office to tweak the detour as we go to ensure that it is as safe and comfortable for pedestrians, cyclists, and motorists as possible. I'm at the corner of Scott and Merton, where you'll see the new entry and exit to the transitway. You'll also notice that there are new signals now at this intersection, including a pedestrian crossing light. It will be important for people to obey that if they're traveling from east to west, since at peak there will be a lot of buses moving into and out of the transitway. There is also a new pedestrian crossing across Scott Street. It is only on the west side, so if you want to cross Scott here, make sure that you do so in the designated crosswalk. This is the multi-use path that runs on the north side of Scott along the transitway. I think for a lot of cyclists and pedestrians, it's going to be a much more comfortable place to walk or bike to work than on the south side sidewalk. It's, as you see, just freshly plowed. This whole area, starting Sunday, will be receiving transit priority snow clearing, which will make it a lot easier for everybody to get around during the detour. You can see how close the new bike lane and buses are going to be to some of the houses further down Scott, as well as to the sidewalk. My advice to pedestrians and to cyclists is to avoid the south side of Scott altogether and get as quickly onto the multi-use path as you can. You'll also see the signage, the right turning arrow, buses accepted. That's your indication that the bus only lane is actually also a right-hand turning lane. Let's take a look at the new lane configurations that are in effect as part of the detour. First, there's an eastbound bicycle lane, an eastbound buses only lane, and an eastbound car lane. There's a westbound car lane, a westbound buses only lane, the multi-use path for pedestrians and cyclists, and the transitway will now exit and enter at Merton Street. I've fielded a few calls and questions from residents wondering how, if they're traveling eastbound on Scott, they'll be able to move into the side streets. The buses lane is also a legal right-hand turning lane. First, make sure that you signal and merge into the bus's lane. Drivers are expected to be courteous and provide you with an opportunity to do so if they see that you need to turn.
Then make your right hand turn, making sure that the way is clear of eastbound cyclists. Similar to making a right-hand turn from Scott Street onto the side streets, if you need to make a right-hand turn from the side streets onto eastbound Scott, first, when it's safe to do so, move into the bus lane. Then, at your earliest safe opportunity, merge into the eastbound car lane. One of the interactions I'll be watching is how east-west users of the multi-use path interact with buses entering and exiting the transitway. When the east-west light is green, buses exiting the transitway will stop north of the multi-use path, leaving the way clear for pedestrians and cyclists. When the north-south light is green and the east-west light red, it will be important for pedestrians and cyclists not to try to cross, since eastbound buses will be making their turn into the buses only lane to continue their trip.
Now, once the detour begins tomorrow, this section of transitway behind me will never reopen from this point further east to bus traffic. Over the course of 18 months, it'll be converted into light rail as they lay down track. A second phase of light rail construction will begin from Merton to Tunney's Pasture, beginning, it's expected, this June. So the detour will then be accomplished from the Tunney's Pasture station. That Tunney's Pasture station is the furthest west of the first phase of light rail. It's the western terminus. The hope is that sometime in 2018, we'll begin to be able to construct from Tunney's Pasture further west as the second phase of light rail goes further west, east and south.